Martin Block bringing you the music of Frankie, Carle, and his orchestra. And you know, those of us who have watched Frankie's spectacular rise to fame in 4 short years are apt to say, there's a lucky lad. He got all the breaks. But we mustn't overlook the fact that half a lifetime of hard work played a major role in his success story. Frankie spent many years as pianist with such top-notch bands as Mal Hallett, Horace Height. Of course, he was always a perfectionist. Spent most of his leisure time developing what in later years would be known as the Golden Touch. In his mind, he visualized a full orchestral accompaniment to one of his favorites, Sweet and Lovely. Someday, he dreamed, this would be his orchestra. That dream is a reality. Frankie Carle now heads one of the foremost musical organizations of our time. Often that we have an opportunity to get an intimate slant on one of our musical stars. So meet the young lady who has all the answers, Frankie Carle's daughter, Marjorie.
How do you do?
Welcome to our musical merry-go-round, Marjorie. I understand you and your dad have been together for quite a while.
Ever since I was born.
I mean as vocalist with the band.
Oh, I've been with the band officially about 2 years.
Oh, you're practically a newcomer.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I cut my teeth on a baton. You see, Dad was a bandsman before I was born, and music has always played a big part in our lives.
Yes, Frankie told me that he even named you for one of his favorite songs, Margie.
That's right. He used to play it in the Butterfly Ballroom in Springfield, Massachusetts, way back in 1924. That was when Dad met another one of his musical sweethearts.
Do I know her?
Everyone does. She was one of the most popular girls in the country when Dad started his career. They called her
Sleepy Time Gal. You're turning night into day. Sleepy Time Gal, you've danced the evening away. Before each silvery star fades out of sight, just give me one little kiss, then let us whisper good night. Sleepy time gal, when all your dancing is through. Sleepy time gal, I'll find a cottage for you. You'll learn to cook it a soul. What's more, you'll love it, I know. When you're a stay-at-home, play-at-home, 8 o'clock, sleepy time gal.
Old-timer, Sleepy Time Gal certainly wears her age well.
She'll probably go on forever.
Tell me, Marjorie, what made you decide to take up singing for a career?
It was Dad's idea, I guess. I used to sing around the house for my own amusement. One day while he was running over a new song, he asked me to sing it for him. It was called Oh, What It Seemed to Be. We were to spend a great many hours rehearsing together before Dad was satisfied.
Seemed to be is more than just a thrill for me. It was a promise, darling, of the things that fate had willed for me. It was just a wedding in June, that's all that it was. But oh, what it seemed to be. It was like a royal affair with everyone there, 'cause you said yes I do to me. That's all that it was.
Understand, that was the first record you ever made.
That's right, Martin.
Well, it's still one of your best. And now, Margie, I want to thank you for this little visit. And to conclude our show, let's listen to another of Frankie Carle's original compositions, Sunrise Boogie.